everyone, it's your friend Think Noodles, and welcome back to Clash of Clans. And I'm building up an army here because I wanted to do some single player. Now, as you can see, Town Hall 6 is complete, and it's like 1.2 million for the next one, and 6 days. What do we get out of it, too? Look at, you get 50 walls, another air support, let's see, a mortar, I don't know what that is. I don't know what this thing is. Is that a Tesla coil, I think it's called? We got a barbarian king. We've got the dark elixir drill, dark elixir storage. I don't know what that is. And more bombs and a black air bomb? Oh, if I upgrade these, do they turn black? Is that what happens? No. Okay. okay, so I've got Town Hall 6. And what I did... Okay, first of all, I feel like I waited a little bit too long to upgrade it. And the reason I say that is because, I waited until I had a million, right? A million of both. Then I upgraded this, and then it brought me down to 250,000 gold. But I think it was a 4-day upgrade, I think. But I had upgraded everything. My walls were fully upgraded. Every single structure was fully upgraded. My wizard tower, everything. I know that people are like, hey, you need to upgrade your troops. You upgraded, or you went to Town Hall 6 too quickly. But there was nothing left to upgrade other than my resource collectors that were at level 9. And if you can see, I can't upgrade past level 10 anyway. So it didn't make any difference because now, I'm upgrading these level 9s to level 10 and that's it. So I don't have two levels to upgrade them. Anyway, so that was annoying because I got maxed out on gold and elixir. A million and a million. I had nothing to spend it on. I didn't want to raid anyone because, well, what was the point? I mean, I wasn't going to trophy push because I don't have, I'm getting close. 516 gems, almost to the 550, and then I'm going to go and I wanted to upgrade my gold storage to 10, but I didn't have enough elixir, so I upgraded an elixir storage, but and then I'm going to get my 1250 trophies, get 450 gems, and boom, fourth builder, which is going to be sweet because... right now, that's kind of what I need is more builders. Everything's taking a long time to upgrade. Now, what I did is I took my own advice, and I think it was good advice because it worked pretty well this time around too, is that my new gold mine, I put those in right away and just started working back and forth on those with my builder. And it's great because these are producing 1,300 per hour, and it only took, I think the longest so far was 6 hours for each one to upgrade, because I think the next one is 12, right? Yeah, so I think total time to upgrade this was 7.5 hours or something to level 6 to get 1300 extra. And again, same deal, upgrading this gives me 300 per hour and it takes 3 days, so good advice. Now I'm not upgrading any of my defenses. As you can see, I'm only upgrading these. I'm also upgrading my lab so I can research better troops, because my troops were all maxed out. The reason for that is because we have a war starting soon, and I know that if I go, let's say I upgraded this wizard tower to level 1 or this one to level 3, it's out of commission when people attack my base. Now, during war, I don't know if that's the case, but I worried that it was. So I was thinking, let me upgrade my wizard tower. Let me upgrade my my mortar. I did upgrade this one to level 2, but let me upgrade my mortar to level 4. Can you do that in this one? Yeah, okay. But then I was like, wait, if we're in war and I'm upgrading my defenses, I might lose my base and get 3-starred, and I don't want to affect my team that way. So, also, you may notice that all my Christmas trees are gone. Well, I did that about 10 minutes ago because I was recording and my computer crashed again. It's really annoying. It only does it when I record Clash of Clans. I don't know why. But anyway, I removed the Christmas trees and I left one single Christmas tree in the corner with a present because I recorded the last episode before the presents actually ended, even though all the comments were like, hey man, the presents ended, you can just get rid of them. But when I recorded that video, they hadn't yet. So, I had a few more presents that I picked up, and yeah, so I'm leaving that one. I'll probably end up accidentally clicking on the present at some point, but it would be cool to, by Christmas time next year, to have this tree clicking very very closely, and not hitting that tree or hitting the present, and to have the present there. But I'm keeping that tree. And it was true, when you do remove the tree, you get $75,000 for it, and it costs you $25,000 to remove it, so you get a net of $50,000. Now, let me check what we have here in my army camps. I wanted to do a single-player attack. I kind of wanted more giants. Because I played a little bit of single-player. That was the one thing that I did do. I got rid of all of these, and then I tried this one, and I was like, oh, no. So I think I need giants for it, and I'll show you guys why. That was really the only thing I could do, was spend some elixir on troops and then go and do the single player. Oh, wait, why am I not training? What's going on here? What's going on here? Let's see. Let's do like that, and then we'll put three here, and then... So let me show you guys my war base, because we are going to have a war soon. Let's take a look here. That's interesting. Weird. I didn't ask for these, so these are left over from the last one. I'll keep them. Although level 2 archers is not that good. I'm gonna get rid of those, and then I'm gonna ask or war, and see what we get. We might get something a little bit better. Let's see if that helps. I've got the minion. I don't know. I just, maybe some better troops might help. So let's go check out my base here, and so you guys can see it is redesigned. I've got all the new stuff in here. Now let me talk you through it a little bit. What I decided to do was, obviously, I put these out on the outside, and you guys should do this. Always keep your town hall in the dead middle for war. You do not want anyone getting there, because that's the third star. Put your resource, normally you keep these very well protected, your storages. Don't worry about them, because they're not really taking your money. It's just something else that's in the way. And they do have a lot of hit points, so they're good to absorb it, unless the people use goblins and then you're in trouble. But I put those on the outside, and now I put the archer tower, and I alternated the archer tower and the wizards just for coverage. So overlapping coverage. Mortar here, mortar here. Now I thought about this, and I did on this side, and because I thought they would come after the wizard tower first, because that is one of the best defensive structures, so they'd probably come after that and try and get the mortars. So I put a bunch of bombs and things in here just to, I don't know, hopefully get rid of some of their troops. And then I put some here as they're, if they come in this way, and try and get to my town hall. So, and then I put a big bomb down here because someone might come directly toward the clan castle. So, I don't know. Nobody's giving me troops. Why? It's weird because there's a lot of people on right now, but it might be that they want to give better troops or whatever, but it's kind of full, so... Okay, guys, I think that I've got what I need. Well, in a second, I should. Well, 8 seconds, I should. Because I wanted like 6 giants per archer tower or so. So let me... I'll just take the extra one while I talk. So let me tell you. I want to tell you guys to keep trying to get in to the clan. And the reason I say that is because every once in a while someone will do something bad, and I kick them out. What I have all of the other noodlers do is, if anyone says anything bad in the chat, just send me a screenshot and email, and I take care of things, because we don't tolerate that in the Golden Noodlers clan. Family friendly and all that stuff, just like I operate my channel. Now, other reasons that I may remove people, and there's no one else, there are no elders in the clan. I'm the only leader. I'm the only one who can make decisions like that. So I keep it, I guess, under control, and it goes pretty well. Now, the other reason that I may kick someone out is because of inactivity, and not because I'm like, oh, I hate you because you're inactive. It's not that at all. It's that. I want to give the opportunity for more active noodlers to play in the clan and have fun with us. And So, and let me, so always, what I'm saying is always check to see if there's space. It does go really fast when I do remove someone. It's a little bit, it depends, the time of day, but it's around 30 seconds, when a spot is gone. but it happens. So always check, because I'm always keeping an eye on whether people are active or inactive. And and let me say this too. To those of you guys who are in the clan, or if you get into the clan and you're like, oh my goodness, I don't want to be inactive. I got to play every single day, every hour of every day. That's not what I mean by inactive. Of course, things come up. I mean, even me, I don't play every single day. Well, maybe I do, but some people can't, and that's okay. What I mean by inactive is, you know, we've had 3 clan wars in 3 separate weeks. You haven't participated in any of them. I check your base, and it is completely filled with, you know, logs and trees and stuff. Your base is thrashed. You haven't repaired any of your traps or anything like that. I can tell, you know, you probably haven't played in 2 or 3 weeks. Then that's inactive. If you haven't played for a couple of days, a week, totally fine. But if it's like, you know, if it's like 2-3 weeks, okay, maybe you're not interested in Clash of Clans or the clan anymore, and I want to free up the space for other noodlers. So I do that every once in a while, guys. So keep an eye on it. You never know. It could happen. It has happened to people. They kind of freak out. It's kind of funny when they come to the chat, like, ah! They're like, I'm running around the room screaming my head off, that sort of thing. It's really fun. I love letting you guys in and doing that. And when I do, and the great part is, obviously, when I remove someone, I'm on. So when you join, welcome! So it's pretty fun to interact with you guys. I love it so much. So let's go and do this single player part. We're not going to get to the war today, but... and this is a tough one because look at this. It's got the 2 mortars. The 2 mortars, it's got the 4 cannons, and then it's got the archer towers. And I'm going to try and take out the archer towers. Oh, there were spring traps. So I'm going to try and get rid of the spring traps here. Let's see if I can... there we go. And here too. Let's see. Oh, nice. Okay, that actually worked really well. Can I get them to... Oh, yeah, okay. Yeah, I just want to... I want my... Okay. Okay, all right. So let me put my giants. 5, 6. Oh, I put 7, that's okay. There, okay, that hopefully will get rid of the archer tower, because these are really, really powerful archer towers. If that happens, yes! Oh, wow, actually I put too many giants. I guess I could have gotten away with less. Now, there's no more air defense, and you guys know the drill. I'll put 2, 2 down, just to sort of speed it up a little bit. But, yeah, sweet. I got this one. It was, you know, it was actually, what I need to do, this is my big problem with single player, is that I go into it and I see it and I go, I could take this thing. And I don't really think about it logically. And with my troop, makeup, I'm like, I got all these troops. Why not use them? And I'll fail because I haven't planned for it. What I need to do is have like empty army camps and then go and look at it, because you can go into it and then you can just end battle. You know what I mean? And you don't lose anything and you know what you're looking for. And then you can go ahead and beat it up like this. And we're almost done. And done. There we go. All right, guys, I think that's it for today's episode. I guess I'm gonna start training my army for the war. And I'm actually gonna try, because a lot of people said that the wizards and giants is a really good, strategy or troop breakdown. So I'm gonna do that. I don't know what the ratio should be, but I'm gonna go with like maybe 1 giant for every 2 wizards. So let's see. So I had 12. Let me go 13, 14. That makes 1 more, and then 1, 2. Okay. Well, anyway, goodness, it's gonna take forever to train, but that's okay. That is okay. I've got my spell ready, which is sweet. And it's level 4, which I think is gonna really help. Hopefully I'll go to someone who doesn't have any troops in their clan castle. Probably not true, but not. But anyway, and then I could use it on their base, but whatever. All right. Well, anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed this episode of Clash of Clans. If you have any suggestions, post them in the comments below. And if you enjoyed it, go ahead and give it a thumbs up. I'll see you guys again soon. Thanks for watching. And of course, noodle on.